Hi guys. It's 11:15, Tuesday evening. I don't believe I had to stop and think about that. That's actually not the first time I've actually had to think of what day was it. I don't know, my brain just forgets things like that. For me, one day after the other, it's just a day. I've been busy since Saturday. Saturday I had a delivery of a load of electrical bits and pieces. Only small things, mostly cables, and some computer bits, which I'll show you in a moment. Sunday I was at Mum's and we had a barbecue. Invitation by our neighbours, or her neighbours I should say. So that was actually pretty good. I do like her neighbours, now that I've met them properly. It's only taken 4 months, but yeah, they're alright. Yesterday I was at Mum's again, because stepdad picked me up to help empty his car, the Toyota, of all the crap for the dump that was in there. I had a nice roast dinner yesterday, nice roast chicken. I don't know what the heck that was. Yeah, today I've been sorting all the cables, basically, out of a good 5 or 6 boxes I got. I will put the video of what I've got in the shed on the end of this vlog so you can just get some idea of what I've got in the shed. I've got 12 printers down there. A half a dozen boxed, sealed toners, which I'll probably put on eBay at some point, I think. No doubt someone out there is probably using one of the printers that use one of those toners, so. Right here, as you can see, one. This has currently got, apart from the few laptop batteries, just, actually, that one shouldn't be in here, that's a missed, but that's USB cable. This is basically, you know, sort of audio and video type cables, as SCART leads, and these adapters, you know, we can plug, like, 3 devices into one, it's handy. So you can't run devices at the same time because the signals interfere with each other. You know, there's audio cables and... I'm actually wondering if my brother might have a use for that. Because that is an XLR cable. And as he and his boss, they do discos as well as a bunch of other things. Entertainment related. Nothing dirty before anyone says anything. It's, you know, they do, not the catering side, but they will host the parties and whatnot and do the discos, so he might actually want that as a spare cable. But yeah, that's what's in that box. One underneath is I know the lights aren't very bright, but they'll help. Ink cartridges, sealed in boxes, most of them. Some of the boxes have opened up, but a lot of them have still got the price stickers on, so I'm guessing this was old stock left on a shop shelf. I'm guessing that's where a lot of these came from. Probably, maybe not necessarily a actual computer shop, but a shop that sold similar things. This one is just full of laptop adapters of all sorts. The bottom one is just various other power adapters. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with those. Ideally, I could do with, like, putting a cardboard partition in this box and separating them so I can then put two different things in them and just take it to the car boot like that. I'm sure I can car boot something. That is a long Ethernet cable I'm going to keep to replace either that blue one or the one that runs into my bedroom, because all of these ones I've got, the bloody clips are broken off. So they keep falling out of the back of the router up there, which is annoying. It really is annoying. So a router of some sort, but you don't plug an ADSL line. See, with my router up there, I've got the ADSL cable that goes from that filter up to the router, because I don't know if many people know how it works here. We don't have a separate cable come into our property for our internet. It's all done on the phone line. So we have these filters that plug in, which allow us to use the phone and the internet at the exact same time. And I've got loaded these in that box because that's all phone related cables and items. Ethernet related cables in there. That box right there is full of PC related cables, like VGA cables, USB cables, etc. Then I've got another box just in front of the clear tub that's got European and American power cables in it. But yeah, this will go to a little green box which sits somewhere out on the road. It could be on the corner of a road, but you can't miss them. They're all over the place, and they are the phone exchanges. And when BT upgraded to fibre optic around here, they put in special exchanges to that. So basically this phone line, or at least the internet part of it, will, or that from here it will go to the main phone exchange, which is literally almost a stone's throw away from here. You just go to the end of my road, which is about 200 yards. That's where it is. And then of course the internet connection itself will then go from that to the fibre optic exchange that they installed. So yeah, that is how the system works here. And basically all other providers that provide us with the phone and internet basically just rent the line from BT. BT owns the lines. Some providers will cap your speed if you go over your data allowance or whatever. Unless you're like me and got the unlimited version, because I do leave this PC on all day. So, I don't do much in the way of downloading, but I do watch a lot of YouTube videos, which will eat through a data allowance. And I do play the odd Facebook game, which again will help to eat through your data allowance. So, right, I'm gonna move. Oh, I've got this Apple PowerBook Duo here. Doesn't work, unfortunately. Every time I try and connect power to that, the cable gets extremely freaking hot and I have to switch it off. So there's obvious a dead short on that power somewhere. I know the battery itself has leaked and I have actually thrown it in the bin. So maybe there's some leakage there that is short of contact, though. I don't know. I'll take it apart and have a look. If I can salvage it, great. If I can't, I'll just stick it on eBay as spares or repairs. And this stuff didn't come free. Did have to pay for it. And because I am an honest bloke, I paid 80 quid for it. Well, actually, I've got to pay him the rest later this week when I get some cash in. So, but I don't think I've got a total loss here. If I hadn't bought any of this that I'm showing you, it would have just gone down to the scrappy and all be weighed in, especially the cables. He could have weighed that in a scrap. So I'm just going to let the kitchen light come on. Right. So turn around. There is, right there, two laptops. They're dead, so they're spares or repairs as well. One's a Toshiba, one's a Samsung. One's actually got a Windows 7 sticker on it, so I could probably push for £20 buy it now, even though it's spares or repairs. Actually, nah. I'll put them both up at buy it now, 15 quid or best offer. So I know someone will offer me a tenner for each of them, so there's 20 quid made back right there. That one, I've got two. Have I got to put a hard drive in it? Yes. No. No. Hard drive is in it, so I've just got to install Windows. But I'm going to hold off on that, because my brother's got an 80 gigabyte SATA hard drive that I'm going to upgrade that to. Because that's got an IDE drive in it at the minute. Just because it'll help make Windows operate faster. Because I've got four cases like that. Some of them actually came with these drives, you know, the DVD writer card reader combo. This one has on the floor hasn't, but the actual case is exactly the same. Motherboards were slightly different, but they were all upgraded to Windows 7 from Windows XP. And most of them, or all of them apart from one, I've got six of these cases in total. One was, I've got a white one in the lounge, which is Windows XP. Not really much use these days, but this one is actually up and running. It's got, I've upgraded it to 2 gigabytes DDR2 memory. It's running Windows 7. It does run it quite nicely. It's not the fastest thing on the planet, but if someone's just looking for something, you know, to stick in their kid's bedroom, a cheap unit, you know, to keep the kids quiet or something, then that is what this is going to be aimed at. So I'm not going to be asking a great deal for it, but I was considering upgrading to Windows 10, but I thought, nah, you know, as the old saying go, don't fix what ain't broke. I've got 8 monitors in total. That one, that had Windows 7 installed on it. I pinched the hard drive out of that because I fixed one of these up for a friend. Because like I said, I've got 4, but I've only got 2 here. It's because my brother pinched one. He pinched one last night when he came up here because he wanted a project to play with. So yeah, that one's actually just got a, I don't even know why they bothered putting Windows 7 on that, because it's only an old AGP, or well, that's the graphics slot it's got on it, AGP, and it's got DDR memory, you know. But I like the case, and I'm going to have a look and see if I've perhaps got a motherboard I can shove in there that will take DDR2 memory and allow me to upgrade it to Windows 7. But yeah, that one's running. I've just got to photograph it, basically, in working condition. That monitor's going to come with it. That keyboard. I've got plenty of USB mice. I think I've got about 10 of these. I could throw. I can throw in the mice as well. And I think I've got well over 20 of these in the shed. This type of lead. So I include those. VGA cables I've got, I'm not worried about that either. This thing I've got to see if it works. It's just a little dinky little Ethernet switch. Probably a cheapy one. Although it doesn't look that old actually. I haven't checked that one, but over here I've got this one which does work. Which is, well, once you've plugged your internet in, you've then got seven other ports that you can connect. You can connect seven computers to it. And I'm no expert on networking, but I'm guessing you can use these switches to network things like printers to computers. I'm not an expert. I've got three of these in switches as well. They work. I've got these, which they call it a router, but there's no ADSL socket on the back. It's just Ethernet in and then Ethernet out, basically, with Wi-Fi. And I actually, I've got the driver disk for these, because tried these, couldn't get them to work. The computer there wouldn't connect, because I tried it via the cable. But I found this tender driver disk there, installed it on the PC, tried these again, and these work. And they work while connected to the main router. And I know from experience that main, if you try and connect two main routers like that, that I've got in the lounge, together, so like you wanted one in one room and one in the other room, it wouldn't work. They will just interfere with each other and cancel it out. But you can use something like this, or a Wi-Fi extender, which is what I've got here. Well, they call this a range extender, because literally on the back, all it's got these two big antennas, Ethernet on the back and the power, and that is it. So you run an Ethernet cable from your main router into this, and you could sit this somewhere else in your home, like upstairs, because I've got these really long Ethernet cables, so you could run it upstairs. If you've got a wide house, you could run it from one side to the other, and you could use your laptop quite easily outside without the worry of losing a signal. Or even if you are a generous neighbour, you could like put this near a window so your neighbours can sponge off your internet. That actually wouldn't bother me, because I've got unlimited data anyway. So, but I think I will be keeping at least one of these for myself, at least one of those router things for myself. And I've got a use for this switch, so, because I'm gonna, in the bedroom, I'm gonna have we'll head that way in a minute, all those computers on that bench. So I figured, rather than have four and keep swapping the cables, I might as well go as far as I can. And this has come along, so I'm going to be using that one. Got a bunch of USB Wi-Fi adapters there. Don't know if they work, but the one I gave my friend did. Didn't even have to go and download any drivers for it. We just plugged it straight in, Windows 7 installed it. And before he left, I did connect to my router and get a website up and whatnot, just to check it did work. So yeah, I've got another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 up there. Hang on. I've got this one here, but I don't know what it is, because it doesn't say Wi-Fi or wireless G or anything on it. It's just got a serial number, the power rating, and a model number. That is it. And I can't read it. I need my magnifying glass. This one doesn't even have anything on it. And I've plugged it into a computer and it installs, but nothing comes up. I haven't got a freaking clue what it is. That could be another little Wi-Fi adapter. I don't know. Right. Pardon me. I think that is it for in the kit. No, it isn't. I've got those two routers as well that I want to check. Got a Linksys one. I've also got a Linksys access point. You see, they call it a range extender on that, but the access point I've got looks exactly like this, but it's only got the one Ethernet port on the back, like the Tender range extender. So it does pretty much does the same thing as a range extender, that it's just Linksys have called it a different name. Part of them power supplies, not tested yet. Printers, I haven't tested yet. That's a computer another guy gave me, which is pretty much ready to just button up and sell as is, which I will. I'm sorting out that drawer of cables. And when I can get over there, I've got three drawers I want to sort out over there as well. I want to transfer, well, I want to go through that drawer there. But basically, I want to transfer what's in these three drawers to those drawers, because I barely use, well, I've always got that corner blocked off, as you can see. So I want to put the stuff that I don't use often in that corner and all the cables in here. I'll do the same when I'll go through the boxes in the other room and, dearie me, I do apologise. I'm a touch of the windy poos tonight. Whew. That white box is where the Linksys extender thingamajig is. That monitor is actually rubbish. It died. I will double check it, but it had died. It's just the power light kept flashing and the screen kept flashing. It just kept doing that sort of attempting to power up cycle. And there is a reason why they do that, and I can't remember it off the top of my head. So I do watch a guy on YouTube that repairs flat screens and whatnot. There's that Dell monitor there. I'm keeping that one. If it works. I haven't actually plugged it in to try it. I only need a couple of these to put with a couple of these. actually, I only need two. So as long as like that one or one of those three work, it doesn't matter. I've sorted what was out in that box. I've got some more adapters down there to go in boxes through the lounge. I've got some CD drives down here. Rollerball mice. There's another one, two in there. Bag full of, there's four in there. Five, six, I've got six, did I? Right, well, they can all go. I've got a red tub under there, I'll stick them in there. Hard drive caddies for laptops. I've got no idea what they go to. As in what laptops they go to. I don't know if it's going to say in there. I've noticed some things I got from here actually had labels on, like the batteries. If any have got labels on and I can, you know, list them saying what they go to, then I'll list them on eBay. That bag is full of disk drives, again, unknown. I've got to find a way to test them. I'll test these disk drives as well. I just want to connect them to a power supply and just see if they open and close. These speakers, believe it or not, will plug into the back of these monitors, even though they've got the thingy style. RCA? Is that what they're called? I can't remember now. I actually can't remember. And there's a load of shit on the bed. I've got five AGP graphics cards over there. That motherboard came with it, and it's got that weird looking 4 GB card plugged into a... I'm going to focus. Thank you. Plugged into an IDE socket on that IDE, the primary IDE, I might add. Don't think there's anything installed on it, because there's a hard drive, or I've got a hard drive through here that was with it. I've got a couple of keyboards. I've got that one, there's another black one somewhere that I can include with these PCs, so that's not a problem. Mm. I think Nemo wants his dish topped up. It's getting that time. Surprised the phone hasn't rung yet. There's one more item that I need to check. Where is it? Why have I got that up there? Where is it? How big are you? I can't bloody find it. He says in the bloody corner and I can't find it. Tells you the power. I don't even know why it was up here. I can't remember. That's not what I was looking for. There it is. A little Dell PDA, palm top computer thing. Let's see if I can get that one up and running. Oh, there we go, I found it, 160GB. I could stick that in one of the computers, I suppose. I have got like 500s and whatnot in the cupboard, so I have got the bigger ones. Right. So yeah, I've been a busy chappy. I need a pee. I have to do that in a minute. I'll do that when I go and feed Bonzo. Well, there's the phone, so I'll be back in a moment. And we're back. Mum was a bit late this evening. Sometimes she is, I suppose it depends what she's watching on TV or doing on the laptop or whatever. I'm gonna have to go to bed soon, I think. I've got to get to the bed first. You'd send what I've got on there. There's actually a plastic tub that I want to get to, and I can't get to it yet. I'm not doing any more tonight, it's just gone midnight. I'll clear the bed and battle on tomorrow. That just made me jump. I forgot I turned the sounds back on. I had it muted in the top of the browser up here. You know, you can get the little mute symbol, and then I couldn't work, or wasn't. Shall I try that again? I was wondering, bloody hell, why I wasn't hearing any notifications like that, because I'd forgotten I'd muted it. Right. Oh, this has just reminded me. I've got to reply to her in a minute, because I wasn't actually implying she was cheating. It was just something I'd stumbled across. I don't know if anyone ever sees these pop up on their Facebook, these random quizzes you can do. But actually, show you what I could show you. You can easily cheat to get 10 out of 10 on these. Look at this. All you've got to do is do the quiz, answer the questions. I can't remember. That was 2005. remember some of these. Right, I didn't get to check my score button. We check that. I've got 7 out of 10. Share results or cancel? Well, if you go to cancel, so you get left with the quiz with the correct answers. So that's the one I got wrong, that's the one I got right. I can swap it. So what I've got to do is now go up. Here's this one, 1992. 1984, we correct that one like that. So now, I've got four correct answers. When I click this again, look how easy that is to cheat on this. Really? I don't do that when I'm officially doing it, but this was just something I noticed when I, because I don't share them all, so you even get two ticks now when you write answers. Whoever designed these quizzes didn't quite think of that, did they? Right. Nemo needs food. Let's go do him. Right. A bottle of cola in the middle of the floor. I should put that in the fridge. Preferably before I piss over it and end up on my ass. I'll stick you guys on there. This is quite a robust camera. I dropped this earlier. And it still works. I would have been one pissed off puppy if it didn't work. Ah, what have I done with that? What's up here? Right. My landlords have sent me a survey thing to fill in. I can't complain about Victory too much. I have known. Worse housing authorities than them, so obviously they're not perfect. They are actually a charity, believe it or not. I can't complain about their contractors either. Although the contractors they brought in to refurbish the kitchens and bathrooms were shit. Actually, the guy that came last week to sort the flush out on my toilet, he took one look at it and he said, "Did Foster's fit this?" And I said, "Yeah." He said, "Say no more." They were sort of like the sort of Bodger and Scarpa types. Or at least the plumbers were, it seemed. Right, that's not done. Somewhere in a bag. I've got a loaf of bread for the morning. Thought I'd grab it so I didn't have to go out in the morning and get something for breakfast. Right. I actually can't be bothered to do any more testing tonight. I don't think I'll bother testing those Wi-Fi adapters. I think I'll just test them as and when I need them. Yeah, something else I want. I'm getting a little bit thirsty. I want to play GTA, but I can't. Because I've got all that crap in front of the TV. Right. I've got to decide what I want to put on eBay. Could probably do those two laptops, actually. Yeah, but I'll do that tomorrow. I'll get all the photographs taken and whatnot. I think I'll put the European cables up on eBay as well. Just for the simple reason, there's always people travelling to Europe, so using the actual European power cable for your laptop power supply or whatever would be a lot safer than using one of them epoxy horrible little adapter things. Here we go, got that box of Bionicle, that sold. That sold last night actually, my box of Lego Bionicle. So, I've got to pack all that and get that posted off. I'll do that Thursday. Shut this window. It's getting quite chilly when I get up in the mornings because the sun rises on that side of the flat. So the bathroom and kitchen is lovely in the mornings. Bedroom and lounge here is bloody cold. But then it's vice versa in the afternoons because that big window of this lounge tends to become a greenhouse when the sun bears down in here. Oh, that's where I put it. I think that's a little Wi-Fi adapter as well. My brother's got my other one of these, which is actually a Wi-Fi adapter. Because that's the only one I had at the time that would work on Windows 10. So I'll give it to him to use. Because I don't really use them, and the laptops I use have got built-in Wi-Fi anyway. I do have some XP laptops and things stacked in the bedroom that doesn't have them built in, so... Oh yeah, I forgot, I've got these as well. Hard drive docking stations, there's two of these. That one's got a built-in card reader, so I kept that one for myself. Tried to sell one on the car boot Sunday, didn't sell, and I was just talking to my brother and, you know, mentioned these, and he just asked how much did I want for it. I said £5 is what I was trying to get for it at the car boot, and he said, all right then, I'll give you a fiver for it. So he's bought the other one to use on his PC and whatnot. Ooh, this is going to be fun. I need to cut a piece of card to separate that box. So I could put like the phone cables one side and perhaps the Ethernet's the other side. Because the plan is, if I can do that with these boxes, then I haven't got to set anything up at the other end. I've just got to open a box and put it out. Because my sister won't be with us this weekend. She was with us this last weekend, so we didn't have, or I didn't have as much room in the car to put as much stuff. Plus, I didn't have any of these cables sorted anyway. Printers, if any work, I'll probably put those on Gumtree. I've tried those on car boots before. No interest, so I don't do anything like that. Same with these monitors. That computer I'm going to stick back under here. This one I want out. Like I said, I think just for tonight, I just want to make a bit of room so I can get to bed. Get to the bed, rather. So I'm actually going to empty that box and move it, but why don't I just chuck what's on the bed and what's on the floor here in that box? That would make better logical sense. Those adapters I'll take through to the lounge and get all those put where they're meant to be. Yeah. Move those monitors, get those stacked up, and I can get that chair out of the way. Right, I'm going to do that, so I'm going to call it a night, I think. But once I've done that, I'll call it a night, I should say. Yeah, so, bit of a long vlog, but plenty to talk about. That's why I've been leaving it, you know, 3 or 4 days between a vlog. Actually, there's a vlogger I watch on YouTube. He used to do one every day, guaranteed. Now he doesn't, because he just wants a break from picking up the camera, and like me, he just rarely has anything to talk about. I found that one out. When you try to do it, you know, every day, you just don't have anything to talk about. You run out of stuff, so. Right. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you do like this video. If you did, give me a like. It's much appreciated. And thank you in advance to anyone who does. Feel free to subscribe. And again, thank you to anyone who does subscribe, and thank you to all my current subscribers. And I'll talk to you again soon. Possibly at the weekend. We'll see. Anyway, talk to you later. Bye.